projectile motion, definition of success problem. Number 10, you are the quarterback for an NFL team. There is time for only one more play, and you need a touchdown. You throw the ball from an initial height of 2 meters at an angle of 30 degrees. Your target is your receiver's arms 30 meters away and 1.1 meters above the ground. The fans are all hoping you succeed. Now, in this problem, what we are asked to find are the initial velocity and when the ball is caught. Now, this problem itself does not give us all of the values at the beginning of the throw. We know the height at which it's thrown, 2 meters. We know the angle at which it is thrown, 30 degrees above the horizontal. However, we don't know the initial velocity. And because we don't know the initial velocity, we can't solve this problem by setting it up as a well-formed question. If you think about it for a moment, the well-formed question you might ask, given that V0 is the unknown, is what is V0? Well, V0 is a constant, and it's going to be a little bit trickier to formulate that answer. So in order to solve this problem, we need to decide what it means for the throw to be successful or for the throw to be unsuccessful. Well, interestingly enough, if it weren't a physics class, you could probably get this answer fairly easily. The successful trajectory looks something like that. It lands in the receiver's hands. Unsuccessful trajectories include throwing the ball too fast, that means the same initial angle, but by throwing it too fast, it goes completely over the receiver, or throwing the ball too slowly, and then in that case, given the initial angle, it falls short of the receiver. Now, what we need to do in this problem is we need to decide what it is that makes the green trajectory the desired result and define that characteristic of the green trajectory mathematically. Once we have made a definition of the green trajectory, that definition will lead us to a series of equations that will be used to fulfill this definition and thereby lead us to the answer. Now, the characteristic that separates the green trajectory from all the others is simply that the ball lands exactly where it should in the receiver's arms. You might imagine that in order to characterize that, you could say, aha, I wish for the ball to have a height, y, equal to 1.1 meters. Well, that's close. It's part of the answer. But in fact, all three trajectories have the ball with a height of 1.1 meters. The blue trajectory has the ball having a height of 1.1 meter over here. The red trajectory has the ball having a height of 1.1 meter somewhere off the right-hand side of the screen, maybe about down here. As a result, it is not correct to ask simply that the ball have a height of 1.1 meter. Instead, what we have to ask is that the ball achieves a height of 1.1 meter when it's located here at x equals 30. That is our definition of success of this projectile problem. Formulating that definition of success in a mathematical manner will allow us to solve the problem. Here we go. The characteristic that makes the green trajectory successful, whereas all the others are not, is that the y-coordinate of the football is equal to 1.1 meters when the x-coordinate of the football is equal to 30. This expression would imply that all we need to do is find the relationship between x and y, plug in 1.1 for y, plug in 30 for x, and then solve for the appropriate initial velocity, and we're done. Unfortunately, it's not so easy, because there are no y's in the x equations, and there are no x's in the y equations. In fact, there is one and only one variable that is found in both the x and the y equations, and that variable is the time. So in order to satisfy the condition that we have defined for ourselves, we actually need to do so by requiring two things. Number one, we need to require that y at a particular time, we'll call it time of the win, is equal to 1.1. And then, since this is incomplete, we need to furthermore require that x at exactly the same time, time of the win, is equal to 30. By requiring both of these conditions, we guarantee that the trajectory the ball undergoes will land exactly in the receiver's arms and the touchdown will be made. Now that we've listed it as two independent conditions, these conditions imply two particular equations. The first one implies a relationship between y and t. The second one implies a relationship between x and t. So let's write down our formulas. The y-t relationship is that y is equal to y0 plus v0y times t minus 1 half gt squared. Remember, the y-coordinate is the one with a net acceleration, and the x-coordinate has no acceleration, meaning that the x will be x0 plus v0x times t, and that's all. Our request by our two conditions, number 1 and number 2, is to plug in 1.1 for the y value, while t equals t of the win, plug in 30 for the x value while t equals t of the win, and see what happens. And since we believe that those two expressions are sufficient to guarantee that we get the right answer, we expect that these two equations we formulate will have two unknowns. One of them is the one the problem asks for. So let's begin filling in. Looking again at the picture, we notice that the initial y value is 2 meters, the initial x value is 0, but that the initial velocity actually needs to have two different components. The y initial velocity will be v0, we don't know the value, times the sine of 30, and the x initial velocity, v0x, will be v0 times the cos of 30. In this case, it's very simple to fill in all the necessary information. The first equation becomes 1.1 equals y0 is 2, v0y is v0 sine 30. For time, we use the time of the win, the special time, minus half of g is 4.9, time of the win squared. Similarly, we need to fill in numbers into the x equation. We wish x to be 30 at this moment. X0 was 0, and so we'll leave that out, yielding v0 cosine 30 times time of the win. Examining these two equations as a pair, we notice that there are a total of two unknowns. One of them is v0, the magnitude of the initial velocity with which you throw the ball. The other one is time of the win. That means we're all set. As long as we can solve these two equations simultaneously, we'll be able to get the answer. Now we have two choices. We can either solve one of them for v0 and plug it into the other, or we can solve one of them for time win, plug it into the other. Each of these procedures will yield us an equation that has only one unknown, which we'll then proceed to solve. Since part A of this problem asked for v0, I'm actually going to eliminate the variable time of the win first. And I'll do that by taking the simpler of the two equations, which is the second one, solving for time of the win, and then plugging that into the first. So the solution of second equation for time of the win is 30 divided by v0 cos 30. Plugging that into the y equation, yields 1.1 is 2 plus, this becomes a little bit complicated, V0 sine 30 times 30 over V0 cos 30 minus 4.9, and then the rest of it is a little bit complicated. It's going to have 30 squared over V0 squared cosine squared of 30. And just as we anticipated, this expression is now down to a single variable, V0. Initially, it looks like it might be tough to solve for that. However, we're very fortunate. There's going to be a cancellation in the second term, meaning that the only location of V0 in this expression is over here. So let's try to isolate that V0 in several steps. And having done so, we'll be able to get the answer for the initial velocity. Here we go. Let's move the term with the V0 to the left, and we'll put everything else on the right. We will have 4.9, 30 squared, over V0 squared, cosine squared 30, equals, bringing the 1.1 over, 2 minus 1.1 is 0.9, plus sine of 30 over cosine of 30 is tangent of 30 times 30. To solve for V0, I will bring the V0 squared to the right and everything else to the left, yielding a somewhat complicated expression, but nonetheless solvable. V0 squared has a 4.9 in the numerator. It's got a 30 squared. It's still got a cosine squared of 30 in the denominator, but it's now also got this entire expression, 0.9 plus 30 times the tangent of 30. And this yields the expression that V0 is equal to 17.96, which we'll call 18 meter per second. Finally, since we recognize that we began with two equations and two unknowns, those two equations are this one and that one, it's worthwhile to find the second unknown. The second unknown is the time it takes for the ball to travel from the quarterback to the receiver, and that can be solved by plugging our now known initial velocity into the easier of the two equations, which is the second one, to solve for the time of the win. So, simplified, the time of the win is still this expression here, and we can evaluate that as follows. Over V0 cos 30, 17.96 cos 30, to get the result 1.93 seconds. It's important to recognize in this problem, now that we have solved for both part A, what's the initial velocity, and part B, when was the ball caught, how we got here. There was a lot of algebra involved, but mostly I would like to point out that this step in the problem where we were able to write down the definition of success as being y should be 1.1 while x is 30. That step in this problem is what led to the following very simple algebra to lead us to the solution. So, in many projectile problems which can be categorized as hit the target, the key to solving the problem is to be able to write the definition of success. Good luck with your projectiles.